Hi, and welcome to video 7 in the Gatsby JS course. In this video, we'll be getting Fontwesome set up and working in our project, giving us access to thousands of icons. If we look at our design in Gravit, we are using the social icons for Twitter, LinkedIn, and Facebook. These are icons from Fontwesome. If you've not used Fontwesome before, it's a huge collection of high quality, well designed icons. They offer a free tier and paid tiers, where you get access to more icons and customizability. But for now, we'll be using the free tier as it provides what we need for this course. Fontwesome is not just for social icons. If we switch to Fontwesome, and you can go to the icons page by hitting icons in the top bar, you can see that they have 7,000 plus icons. Everything from trash cans through to the Uber logo. People use Fontwesome to build everything from complex dashboards to simple websites. So let's start getting this set up. So first, as usual, switch to VS Code, and we need to import some libraries. So in our terminal, we can write npm install save fontawesome react fontawesome and fontawesome fontawesome-svg-core. Copy this from the description. So the react fontawesome package provides a component which can render the icons into our page. And the SVG core package provides a utility library to handle the SVG rendering. Now we need to import the actual icons. Fontwesome's naming can be a little confusing at times, but they have a range of NPM packages. There's so many icons that usually people don't want all 7,000 icons in their project. For that reason, Fontwesome have split the packages down into multiple packages. We only need the brand icons, so for that reason, we're only going to install the Fontwesome free brand SVG icons. If we just run that, you can also copy that from the description. Once that is complete, we can start our project. I'm just going to clear the terminal and run npm start. And we can start implementing some icons to see if they work. So if we navigate to our homepage, it's the index.js page. At the bottom of the imports, we're going to import our first piece from Fontwesome. So if we import a named export and we want to import it from Fontwesome, React Fontwesome, and from there we're going to import Fontwesome icon. And this is a component that can render the icons onto the page. Give that a save. This is the component to display the icon. Now we can start importing our actual icons. So if we write out the import statement, import, it's going to be a few named exports, so we'll just write it out first and then import them. We're going to import from Fontwesome free brand SVG icons. You'll notice that we never make use of the SVG core library. That's just used in the background by the Fontwesome icon component. We just need to make sure it's installed as a dependency. Now we have this ready, we can start importing our icons. They all start with FA for Fontwesome. So if I start typing FA and then the name of the brand capitalized, so FA space, sorry, not FA space, so FA Facebook, you'll see that it starts coming up with all the available options. For ours, we want the square Facebook logo. So if we just go down in this list, you can see we have the FA Facebook square. So we'll import that. Next, we can get LinkedIn. So FA LinkedIn. And that should come up, perfect. LinkedIn already is a square icon by default, so we can just import that. And last but not least, we need FA Twitter. And we want the Twitter square logo, so they're all themed really nicely. If I save that, that's just ESLint, breaking it into new lines for me. Now we have our Fontwesome icon component and our individual icons, so let's put it to use. Before we do that, let's rename our styled title to homepage styles. And we'll just remove the color for now, and we'll set it to be a div. And the reason we're not using that color anymore is because we set it up in the global component in a previous video. So if I just show you quickly inside our theme, our global styles applies that color automatically now, so we don't need it on that component. So now let's make use of that homepage styles by wrapping it here, and we will wrap that inside a H1. And we're going to want to surround that with parentheses, we're going to go multi-line, Perfect. Now we can start using our icons. So first we start off by writing our Fontwesome icon, like a standard React component. Right, Fontwesome icon, and then we'll just self-close that. And we want three of these icons. To know which icon to use, we pass in the property icon. Into this property, we pass the icon name. So let's see what order that is in our design. So it's Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter. So first we want to copy our Facebook square, put that in. And the next one was LinkedIn, so we're going to copy that one. Create a new icon. And last but not least is Twitter, so icon and FA Twitter square. Let's give that a save. So now we have our Fontwesome icon rendering the icon Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. If we just navigate to our browser, go to our project and give that a refresh at localhost 8000, we can now see we have our three social icons. Yours will be much smaller, it's just because I'm zoomed into 200% at the moment. However, they are too small and the wrong colour. In the designs, they are 30 by 30 pixels and they use a grey colour in the designs like this. So in the design, if we click this, we can see that they are 30 by 30 pixels and they use the grey B9, B9, B9. So let's go back to our VS Code and start styling these up. First of all, let's wrap all our icons inside a div. And we'll give that div the name of icons. And then we'll just cut all of our icons and place them inside the div like so. Now let's start adding the styles to our homepage styles. Inside here, I'm going to create a dot icons selector. And we're going to display inline grid, which makes a grid as wide as the content inside it. Then we want to add grid template columns. Oops, grid. And we're going to set that equal to repeat free auto. And this is saying I want three columns and I want each column to be auto width. And then last but not least, we'll add a grid gap of 10 pixels. Now let's go and check that out in Chrome and see how we're looking. Go back to our project, localhost 8000. If you need to give that a refresh, it was already ready. So you can see now we have a grid with 10 pixel spacing in between each. Again, mine will look much bigger than yours as I am zoomed in. So now we've got that in place, we need to implement the color and sizing on these icons. So if we go back to code, the color was B9, B9, B9. Because we are using Fontwesome and the SVG libraries to import all these icons, they're all rendered as SVGs. This means in our CSS, we can target .icons SVG. And then we can change the color and sizing of each of these individually. So first of all, we want to add the width of 30 pixels and the height of 30 pixels to match our design. Let's give that a save. And then we want to add our color. So like the other areas of the application, we're going to add our color to the theme.js declaration. So inside our color, we can add social_icons, and it was the hex code B9, 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 which is just a light gray. So now this will get passed through to all our styles across the application, and we can access them the same way we're doing down here. So theme.color.background. So for now, we'll just copy this straight out of here, go back to our index.js, and then on our individual SVGs, we'll set the color to theme.color. I think it was .socialicon. Social icons? Yeah, social icons. So give that a save. Now if we switch back to our browser, we have our three social icons size and colored using the Fontwesome library. Now you know how to use Fontwesome, you have access to thousands of icons. And the setup guide you just watched isn't Gatsby specific. So what you've just done will work in any React application. Now that's done, let's continue the homepage in the next video. Thanks for watching.